This is a very personal sort of presentation. It's a very personal point of view, and it's my own sort of search to find my own truth. And I'm going to show you a couple of pieces of work to make the point. It's actually a reaction and my own human response to the world we live in. And it's something I'm looking for to believe in a world of fake news and false promises. So when we speak about emotional data, I'm really trying to look at the sort of what I call the ocean flow of myself, the ocean flow of yourself, going to a place where nobody can lie and only truth exists. And from that truth, find meaning for brands and help people connect with each other and with the world we live in. So, sorry if I'm sounding a bit philosophical, because this is my source. Yeah, so I'm revealing to you the source from which some of our work has come from. So what is emotional data? And if Sagar, you can just go forward. It's not an insight. You know, the insight is this marketing word that I find very limiting. It's a confession. And when I speak about the ocean flow, it's that hidden stuff, the stuff that is rarely revealed in any research. It's not the stuff you can observe either. So it's neither an observation, nor is it an insight. It's a truth that goes far below the surface of any form of recognition. It can come from you and yourself, or it can come from somebody you're hanging out with, and she or he reveals it, and you say, shit, this thing exists, and I didn't know it. And then you say to yourself, actually, it's so true, because it's happened to me, you know. So we're looking for the elephant in the room. We're looking for those hidden sort of, you know, statements or things that human beings have, but are afraid to reveal because they don't feel safe about it. But that truth is the truth that can help us save ourselves and make brands far more sort of desirable, because then the brand starts saying, I must stand for this, and therefore I must do something about standing for this. If you go to the next one, I've said emotional data is the GPS of, you know, the soul. I've said here that everyone owns a GPS receiver. All of us, we do that because it's guiding us to our emotional center. It's that search that led us to create a campaign that some of you might have seen, and I'm going to share that with you, the film. So if you can just play that film, please.
मेरी छोटी सी गुड़िया कितनी बड़ी हो गई, घर घर खेलती थी, अब घर संभालती है, ऑफिस संभालती है. आई एम सो प्राउड एंड आई एम सो सॉरी. सॉरी कि ये सब तुम्हें अकेले करना पड़ता. सॉरी कि जब तुम घर घर खेलती थी तो मैंने तुम्हें रोका नहीं. ये नहीं कहा कि ये सिर्फ तुम्हारा काम नहीं है, तुम्हारे हस्बैंड का भी है. पर कहता भी कैसे है, मैंने भी तो कभी तुम्हारी मम्मी की हेल्प नहीं की, और तुमने जो देखा वही सीखा. तुम्हारे हस्बैंड ने भी बचपन में यही देखा होगा, घर घर खेलते वक्त वो टीवी देखने की या न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ने की एक्टिंग करता होगा, और तुम जैसी कोई छोटी सी लड़की चाय बनाने की एक्टिंग करती होगी. उसके डैड की तरफ से सॉरी, तुम्हारे डैड की तरफ से सॉरी, और हर उस डैड की तरफ से सॉरी जिसने कई कई सालों से गलत एग्जाम्पल सेट किया. पर अभी भी देर नहीं हुई. इस सॉरी के साथ मैं अपनी तरफ से एक छोटी सी कोशिश करूंगा, कि घर के काम में मम्मी की हेल्प करूं, किचन का किंग ना बन पाऊं तो कम से कम लॉन्ड्री में तो हाथ बटाऊं। इतने साल एक गलत एग्जाम्पल सेट किया है, अब कुछ सही कर जाऊं। तुम्हारा पापा।
Thank you. Thanks. So you can see it's not just about an insight, it's a confession, it's very personal. And some of these stories come from our own lives. We look at the world and we say, you know, why is it that our dad never says sorry? What if he did say sorry? Wouldn't that change things in the house? You know, and these things lead to work like this one, because it's what everyone's afraid to say, but somebody says it. And that reveals not just one person's story to others, but it's everyone's story. And so you connect. It shows you, in a sense, it shows how vulnerability is important. And when authority is vulnerable, as is in the case of the dad, who's the authoritarian center of the house, change happens. And when the father of the house breaks down, change takes place. That's how we see this, you know. We look for that vulnerable spot where authority can break down. But it's not just that. We also looked at something that Ariel gave us as a brief, which is, they said, Ariel can wash away the toughest, most stubborn stains in just one wash. Now, that's a fantastic promise, but wasn't enough. Because it's an advertising proposition. How do you make it a social proposition? How do you connect it to a larger audience and allow the world to sort of vibrate with it? And so in the process of our sessions, we added just a few lines to that, which is, Ariel can wash away the toughest, most stubborn stains in just one wash, and anyone can do it. And anyone can do it. That's all we added to the proposition and to the communication idea. Because we realize that Ariel as a powder doesn't know if you're man or woman, husband or wife, you know, or mother or father. It doesn't recognize that. It's equal, right? And that was how the idea was born. We're into our fourth year of Share the Load, and we believe we have tapped into a truth, into a confession, and truly a confession that nobody has spoken about, but it's there. So the thing is that somewhere along the way, I started re-looking at the definition of what is creative. Is creative only about imagination? Is creative only about creating new things? Of course, maybe it is. But sometimes creative is also about revealing something that is already there. It's like an architect who unravels, a century-old city. It may be a photographer who captures a moment that nobody saw and suddenly everybody sees. So sometimes creative is not about being creative. It can just be, revealing something that was already there. I realize we're running out of time, but there's something that we do in our office, which is called creative therapy. It's not a brainstorm session. It's we bring people into the room, and they don't have to be from the creative department. Yeah, anybody, anyone who's in the office and who has time for us. We put people in a room and we discuss the category that we are working on. And when we start discussing the category, first everyone talks about brands and they talk about how the category is useful to them. And then slowly as we go along and we very gently start probing about why really are we buying those things, we start finding stuff that is so deep. And it becomes quite scary, actually, because people start confessing, they start revealing stuff that no research can get you. And then there are tears, and people start breaking down. And the beautiful thing about it is everyone's connected, no one's judging. And everyone feels secure that they can say it. And in that process, as we keep breaking down, We find truths that no one otherwise would have told us. It feels in the sense a bit like, are you doing the right thing? Why are we doing this? And we feel, no, maybe it is important because we can sort of look for roots of thoughts that can connect with brands that can make a difference. And that pushes us to keep doing this. Yeah, because sometimes you judge your own actions and you say, well, is this right? Is this the right thing to do? You know, but it works. So far for us, it has worked and we believe we are doing the right thing. And we feel we're doing the right thing, and the world seems to tell us we're doing the right thing. We just go to the next slide. Of course, it was always there. I told you we discovered it. That's all we did. And if we go forward, I already spoke about truth trying to be heard and how people want to say it, but they don't feel it's okay to say it. And that's emotional data for us, right? No one talks about it. We talk about big data, which is as important, but there's also depth of data, which is emotional data, which is pure truth. Yeah. And we go forward. This is a film we did for Mirinda. We don't have time to share this now, but if we go forward, I mean, this is again something that it's called Release the Pressure. Yeah. And the thing about this film, I think we'll go forward, is that we never wrote a single word of this film. Every bit of this film and every person in this film are real, and they wrote their own story. All we did was bring it together and create a platform so that teenagers who are going through that mental stress are given a chance. And of course, we did a lot more. 11 million bottles of Mirinda went across the country with the letters printed on them. Yeah, to break through, so I've got to break something. So that's what we try to do. We go deep so that we can break something so that people feel liberated. And you say, hey, that's a good feeling. I feel good about this because thank you for saying it, you know. And then just the last few slides. This is a film we did. And not just a film, a whole program that we did for Whisper. It's called Touch the Pickle. And it was something that was out there, right? It was out there. We didn't have to do anything. In a confessional session, in a creative therapy session, in a session which is not a brief, but a briefing, we discovered truths that me as a man never knew. And it was all. We just revealed it to the world. We were not at all being creative. We were just recognizing things that most people are afraid to say. And if you go forward, so that was the whole program. And we don't have time to see it, but it did well. It really pushed brand sales. All three of these affected brand engagement and brand sales. And then the last point I want to make is you don't have to be creative to create. Because it's like something I wrote here, like when you're always thinking about things and you start writing. Truth, confessions, emotional data, they lead you to your own humanity. It is no longer advertising. And you don't have to be creative to create something. You just have to reveal something never seen before. Maybe it's your own truth. And that, my dear friends, is emotional data and how it can help you build brands. Thanks so much.